comes to setting goals, our degree of discipline can shape the very outcome of the end result.
So, it's January, and I got this idea that I'm gonna record myself, kind of like a documentary, while I attempt to set a goal at gaining a certain amount of muscle mass and weight gain and cut body fat percentage and gain strength all within a set amount of time. I'm gonna record myself from beginning to end to see if all the planning and preparation and all the short-term goals I put into effect, if I can make all those work to the extent that I can pretty much meet my goal by a deadline. Maybe like a few months I'd hope to gain like 15 or 20 pounds. I'm not sure yet. I just now I'm getting this idea, but I wanted to record it from the start. This is day one / moment one.
In the world of bodybuilding, a number of things are required to be successful. Knowledge, dedication, proper form, proper diet, healthy attitude. But the number one thing a person must have in order to achieve success is discipline.
Since I've been 15 years old, from a professional standpoint, about 3.5 years. Right. I used to own a powerhouse in Michigan. Now I obviously have a partnership here with Fitness 19. I worked at a YMCA, worked out in probably 15 different gyms, from World's Gyms, Powerhouse Gyms, Fitness 19s, to mom and pop gyms. So I've been around for a little while.
Carol's Health and Fitness. Worked out here probably 4 or 5 years and been working here probably a year now.
On average, how many people would you say sign up? The average person that signs up that you don't actually see come in and follow through in a gym is
probably 1 in 3. A lot of people sign up, you see them once, twice when that membership first starts, and then they fade away. You don't see them for a while, and they'll pop up here and there, but nothing worth that they actually dedicate themselves here.
Maybe 10% of the people actually make strides. And their goals, whatever they might be. My opinion on what factors are necessary to stay disciplined. You gotta have a goal, and you gotta be motivated, and I would say you've gotta see some results as you go. You've gotta constantly remind yourself of that commitment. You gotta visualize yourself. So visualization, staying motivated, and education. Whatever that particular goal is that you're trying to reach. The more educated you are, the better off you are.
I finally got my goals down, exactly what I want to do. Right now I'm at 160 pounds, and my goal is to hit 180 in lean mass. And what I'm going to do, at my smaller goals, I'm going to set it to where I can gain 5 pounds within 2 weeks, every 2 weeks. That's a lot of weight to gain. It's 2.5 pounds a week. So in order to do that, I'm gonna make sure daily I get at least 120 grams of protein, shakes, but a lot of lean meats, 3,000 calories plus, which I know is going to be hard to hit every single day, but I'm going to try to get real close to that. 3,000 calories a day, never go longer than 3 hours without eating. I'm going to get 8 hours of sleep a night to give my body the Zen cycle where I'll deep sleep, good muscle building. I'm not going to work out at all when I'm sore. I'm not going to work out that muscle group when I'm sore. John's going to do it with me. He's been at Super Fitness. We're both signed up to Fitness 19. So we're both going to be going there. We'll work out buddies, keep each other going, motivated. So, and he's got his own separate set of goals he's going to make sure he does too.
Ultimately, my main goal is to get to 215, muscular defined 215 by the end of the year. My 8-week goal is to put on at least 5 to 10 pounds of lean muscle mass. So that's 8 weeks. Trying to keep high calorie and high protein intake. I'm going to start this new diet. High protein. I'm at least doubling my weight in grams of protein. So it shouldn't be a problem for me to reach my goal, but hopefully I'm not just passing all that through.
And making nasty farts.
Right. My girlfriend's going to hate me for the next 8 weeks, but it's a risk I have to take. But I also want to watch my body fat. Currently I'm at 9%, average 9%. I don't want that to go over 12. You know, I want to keep it low. The lower the better. I feel better about myself when it's lower. When it's below 10, I feel good. I feel like I'm doing my job.
That's part of my goal, is like the 180 in 8 weeks. I want to get a lot more dense, lean mass in my arms, my shoulders, and my triceps and biceps, because that's my lagging parts, I'd say. I want to tone down my waist, make sure it stays trim.
The main part that I've always had an issue with is my inner chest. So if I can get my inner chest to grow and my upper chest, I'll definitely be satisfied.
In the process of all this, we're gonna hit the gym up, we're gonna get footage of the gym, we're gonna get interviews from other people that are working out, we're gonna take the camera with us to the expo, check out how, you know, the part of the fitness world a lot of people don't get to see. You know, we're in the middle of ordering our supplements right now. This being moment one, hopefully we can have a good ass documentary by the time we're done with this, because it's all a matter of how focused we're gonna be, how determined. You know, and bottom line is, we can't make a documentary if we're not successful. So we're striving for that right now.
We're at almost the start of week two. So we'll see the difference. You're at 180?
180. Starting at 180. Oh, 184.
184?
Yeah.
184, 4 pound gain. Pretty awesome.
That's with eggs and everything in my stomach that you don't want to see come out.
I was at 160. 60 a week and a half ago. We're at the beginning of week two. I'd say I've been doing about everything right, eating all the right shit, getting the right amount of sleep. 62, 163, 165, 166. Right, Scotia under. Just about 166. That's awesome. We're going to gain the most right now in the first few weeks, and then it's going to taper off. So I'm going to keep my goal. What is that? 166. That's 6 pounds up in a week and a half. So we're both on the right track. Approaching the end of week two. So far, both of us kind of got up to, I'd say, like a steady 6-7 pounds, maybe. Maybe keepable mass. Our intensity's up there. We got our supplements in. Trying full scoop eject for the second time. We'll see how that works out. We're going there. Fitness 19, getting some pictures of week two, what it's gonna look like. And so today's just gonna be like a pump day, pump all the muscles up, see how much bigger, what type of difference we make in 2 weeks.
Weeks into our training, we were seeing steady gains. Our weight is just where it's supposed to be, and our strength has increased in all areas. It didn't come very easy though. Through that month, we kept a vigilant focus on our daily intake of proteins and carbs, while watching to make sure we weren't ingesting too much fat calories. We were in the gym at least 5 days a week, and making sure we got the most out of each workout. Definitely made a difference in our muscle recovery was the supplements we were taking. Creatine, glutamine, branched chain amino acids, and arginine were among the few we made sure we always had in our system. And that, along with adequate sleep and a very clean, strict diet, made our strength and recovery in the gym the best it could be. Inside the gym, we were focused hard on executing each movement with the proper form, range of motion, and intensity needed to put the right amount of stress on that particular muscle.
I'm gonna attempt to stay intense. Jack was all right, but I think leg day yesterday must have killed all the carbs. I'm trying to stay intense, let's give this a good shot. That's only the end of week two, we're doing all right.
What was my goal? Goal was to gain about 5 to 10 pounds. Steadily at 185. When I started going to the gym, I was about 180. So I have already gained the 5 pounds that I was looking for. So I'm probably going up to ante there and probably say about 10 to 15 pounds. I'm not too sure if I'm a huge fan of the jacks. It feels like it comes on too quick and wears off too fast. I still like taking the aftershock right after I do the major muscle workout before I do my abs.
We'll be right back.
with the Arnold still.
Day two, the Arnold. I already have 20 pounds of supplements, dragging my ass down. Hopefully get another month supply. That's probably going to be gone. A protein, month supply. Sore from yesterday. Holding up the line.
Yeah.
I'm going for 300 today. I ain't hit 300 by 6 months or more, maybe. My max was 335 in June, but like I said, I lost weight. When I came back to the gym 8 weeks ago, I think I was doing maybe 225 for like two or three. So I lost a lot of strength. I'm going to try to see what I can get back here. If I can max out at 300. Alright, so we're at week 8. Today's April 9th, the very end of the 8th week of our training program. We've pretty much kept consistent with everything we've been doing. Minus, you know, not having protein at certain points, not being able to keep up with an expensive diet, etc., etc. But it's weighing time. Now. 178. That's 18 pounds up. I set a goal for, I think, 15 to 20. I was at 181 week 6 and week 7. I cut back on carbs a little bit, trimmed down. So this is steady good weight for me at this moment. 178, 18 pounds. I did it.
Woo. All right, ending off our 8 week goal, starting off at 180, weighing in now. So that's 12 pound gain in 8 weeks.
You only set a goal for 5-10?
Yeah, 5-10. So I'm on top of my game. You're not.
My definition of the word discipline would be, I think it would be defined probably as somebody who has something particularly they want to accomplish, a goal, for example. And having the ability to make the sacrifice to reach that goal. You gotta have a goal, and you gotta be motivated. You gotta have a goal, and you gotta be motivated. Visualize yourself. So visualization, staying motivated.